It's funny. I don't know if I'm going to say it sadly or okay that summer officially ends today, because this was an unusually hot and difficult summer. Certainly when it comes to the heat in Southern California. And it's funny how when we get close to summer, I'm always so excited to think about school being out and sun being up later. But then at the end of summer, after some of the heat we've experienced, I'm excited about fall.
Oh, so excited.
Or whatever fall will feel like in Southern California. But summer officially ends today at 12:21. So we should be able to name, what was the song of summer?
Ooh.
Every summer has a relationship and a song, right? Every summer has that relationship that you got into. Maybe it turns into something, or maybe it dies down. But Tanya, you and I have had plenty of summer relationships.
Yeah, but I thought you were meaning like celebrity relationship.
No. I'm talking about us when we
I married mine.
Us, yeah. Tanya, you've done it. Sisney, you've done it. We've done it. But basically, we want to figure out, what was the song of summer? So we use the same formula that we used to put together the American Top 40 each week. There's a secret recipe that's locked in the vault.
Oh.
For how to do that. But we look specifically at the 10 weeks from the time LAUSD got out of school June 10th to Labor Day.
Okay.
All right. We used that formula. And math is not my strong suit. So doing all this math overnight was like the boys.
What kind of math do you got to do?
Well, I can't even tell you about the formula.
Oh.
It's been a secret.
Don't act like you
did
the math. You probably made Easton do it.
Yeah. I think Easton didn't report it back. But just me having to pick up the phone to call him to ask him to do it was a lot. Right, I don't want to make a phone call after 7 p.m. And Easton, is Easton around?
He's always around.
Well, if he's nearby, he should come in here for a second. But first, Easton works on the American Top 40 show. He's also an engineer. So he's...
Jack of all trades.
That unexpected American Top 40 producer. Mm-hmm. All right, so number five for Songs of Summer, after using the AT40 equation, was this. Oh, baby,
you won't break my soul. Hey. Okay, I feel it.
Beyonce, Break My Soul. Number four.
That's on point. Okay.
Oh, that was number five.
That's five. We're going countdown.
Oh, yeah.
Countdown.
Okay. We always count them down.
Right.
You know, he does the AT40 countdown on the weekends.
I know. I used to work for it.
That's Ryan Seacrest right there.
I know. I used to use it as an excuse.
You didn't? Did you really work for it, or did you just say you worked for it?
No, I really did.
What'd you do?
What'd you do?
I was a producer back in the day.
What would you produce?
Exactly. Here's number four. We've been doing all this late night. Harry Styles. You wanna, now this is nuts, because this song is like 40 years old, but the song that came out in the equation as number three was this, Running Up That Hill. Kate Bush.
I mean, weird. It's kind of true. This song played all summer.
But that wasn't Beyonce.
Were you born in 1985?
I was born in 84.
So, Tanya, you weren't born.
I was not born.
So when that song came out, you weren't born, and it ranked with the equation as number three for Songs of Summer.
Because of Stranger Things and TikTok and all the things.
Right. Number two. Turn
up the music. Hey, yeah. Turn down the lights.
Lizzo, About Damn Time. And the 2022 official Song of Summer.
It's obvious.
After doing the math and looking at all the different variables we need to plug into the equation, the number one song for summer 2022 was?
As it was. And still number one, by the way.
As he should be.
Oh. 100%.
He deserves it.
14 something weeks.
But
still, number one.
Did you know, like, think about a year and a half ago, we didn't have Harry Styles music like that. It wasn't in the ether. And Tanya, did you ever think that there would be a day that after your successful conversation with him, you would launch him into this superstar? Because she had a very big interview, very popular interview.
With the previous album.
Yes, the previous
album.
Right,
but I think Harry Styles was the one to call you after the interview to say, that was the best interview I've ever had in my life. And I think that's part of the reason why all this stuff is so successful around here.
Yeah, because he was like, I need to make an even better album.
For Tanya.
Yeah, for Tanya. That is the only thing. My boyfriend is not jealous. He does not get jealous about anything.
But we witnessed it.
The one thing that he's like,
not, he's a little touchy. He's a little touchy about Harry
Didn't
Styles.
Didn't he say, like, where he was like, can we just stop talking about Harry Styles?
Yeah, well, like, he was dinner? Like, he's like, yeah, it's not only that he called you, but he also, like, did an extra song that he said he did for you. Like, he's like, it was, it's.
No, he actually said at our dinner at my house, can we not talk about this?
That's what he said. He said, can we change the subject? Oh, there's Easton.
Oh, Easton. Oh, Easton. There he is in the AT40 laboratory. So we just calculated the songs of summer here.
He has a top 40 microphone.
Wait, what? Oh, my God.
I love this guy so
that?
Much.
Yeah.
Is that impressive?
Yeah, except it's not on. No one's trying to turn it on.
There we go. How about that?
Nope, still bad.
Oh, no.
No, that's not on. I think you're using ambient microphone there.
How about that? Is that better?
Oh, wow.
There we go. Well, I'll get the hang of it one day.
Aren't you an engineer?
Also, the fact Ryan knew that is, wow. Honestly.
I'm impressed.
So we just curious. Now, what can you share about how we calculate those songs this summer?
We use a lot of metrics. We basically use the same formula we use for the American Top 40. Based on airplay, based on social media presence, based on fan reactions, and you know,
fan
for this one,
wait, what are we surveying fans?
I hit the bricks. I get out on the street and I talk to people. I say, "What's
really
your favorite
does.
Song of the summer?"
He reaches the beaches and he hits the bricks.
That's right, and I rock the docks. So we look at the 10 weeks from the time LAUSD let out to Labor Day. That's summer to me. I don't know what the Gregorian calendar says, but to me that is summer, baby. Here are your top five songs.
No, we already did
summer.
It.
We just did it.
Yeah, we did.
Oh man, I was so excited to announce it. I practiced
it. We were looking for you for 20 minutes. Yeah, no. So we did it, and as you know, Harry Styles was number one.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, as it was. I mean, how could it not be?
Right? You saw that coming, didn't you?
From a mile away. As soon as I heard that song, I was like, that's the song Summer. Sorry, Nicky Yore. It's Harry Styles. That's it, baby.
You know what time Easton and I start working on the American Top 40 in the morning? Give me the
early.
Time. What time are you in for that?
4:30 in the morning.
4:30 in the morning.
We start.
Special time. I mean, the birds are chirping, yeah, honestly.
No, the birds are not even awake yet. The two of us have an hour and a half before y'all even get here.
I know.
We're working on this chart equation.
I see it on the calendar. I just don't come in for that.
No, but I see it on the calendar, and I should not come in for it. But I do. Easton, thank you very much for your contribution here.
Thank you for having me. It's a blast.
All right. Now, go out and learn how to work the mic. Goodbye. I mean, honestly, I think he plays DJ in that closet when we're not around.
I love him.